Cognitive enhancers are the drugs used to improve the cognitive function, such as memory, attention, and creativity. These drugs are mainly used for the improvement of academic as well as the professional performance. They can also help to reduce the impairment of cognitive function associated with age, head injury, stroke, and some neurodegenerative disorders like Alzheimer's and dementia. It is important to note that use of these cognitive enhancers can cause potential side effects when used inappropriately. Now let us try to understand the pharmacology of cognitive enhancers. Cognitive enhancers are called nootropics or smart drugs. Rivastigmine, donepezil and galantamine. These three drugs are cerebroselective acetylcholinesterase inhibitors in the brain. When these drugs are used orally, most of them are available in oral form once a day. When these drugs are used, they inhibit the acetylcholinesterase enzyme which is present in brain, and they try to increase the acetylcholine activity. And through increasing acetylcholine activity in the brain, it increases the cognitive function. Don't forget that these anticholinesterases are also called as parasympathomimetics or cholinomimetics. Rivastigmine, donepezil and galantamine, these three drugs are commonly used in Alzheimer's disease and in dementia, particularly in Alzheimer's disease. However, these drugs are reversible inhibitors of acetylcholinesterase enzyme, and they are having very less adverse effects. Few adverse effects due to overdoses of these drugs can cause sweating, salivation, abdominal cramps, and sometimes diarrhea. And hypotension and bradycardia is another common adverse effect which is seen with acetylcholinesterase inhibitors. Another cognitive enhancer is memantin. Memantin is a NMDA receptor antagonist. N-methyl D-aspartate is a receptor which is a glutamate receptor. When this receptor is inhibited, it will show cognitive functions. This drug is very commonly used for moderate to severe Alzheimer's disease, and the most common adverse effect with memantin is dizziness. We have few other NMDA receptor antagonists, in that ketamine, dextromethorphan and phencyclidine. Ketamine is commonly used as anesthetics because all NMDA receptor antagonists will have anti-seizure property, analgesic property. They may also have anesthetic property and very commonly used in epilepsy as well. Piracetam is another very important cognitive enhancer. Piracetam is commonly used in dementia. It is also very commonly used in myoclonus. Mechanism of piracetam, it has no specific mechanism, but still piracetam has antioxidant property. It decreases the viscosity of blood in the brain, and it increases the microcirculation of blood in the brain. And through that, it has neuroprotective property. Dementia, condition with decline in cognitive function. We have different types of dementia. Alzheimer's disease is one type of dementia. Vascular dementia, Lewy body dementia, frontotemporal dementia, and mixed dementia. Insomnia and headache are common adverse effects associated with piracetam. Another most non-toxic water-soluble drug which is used as cognitive enhancer is citicoline. Citicoline is very commonly used in stroke conditions. It has neuroprotective action. It increases the oxygen concentration, oxygen supply in the brain, especially in hemorrhagic as well as in ischemic stroke conditions. Citicoline is available through oral route, IM as well as IV. As it is very polar drug, it is water-soluble drug. 90% of the drug which is absorbed from the GI tract is excreted through exhalation. This is very important point. Citicoline is excreted through exhalation, and remaining citicoline is excreted through urine. Citicoline is used in dementia, Parkinsonism, and especially in stroke conditions. Piribedil is another dopamine agonist which is used as cognitive enhancer, which is available through oral. Used in Parkinsonism, and common adverse effects are nausea and vomiting. Ginkgo biloba extract obtained from leaves and fruits. Ginkgo biloba, which is available in oral form, which has cognitive enhancing ability. However, it has many controversies on its mechanism of action. It is considered as neuroprotective agent, and it is used commonly in dementia, asthma, bronchitis, kidney and bladder disorders. These uses are mainly considered by Chinese medicine. Natural extracts from leaves and seeds of Ginkgo biloba has potential effects on brain as well as on certain tissues. These are claimed by Chinese medicine. So Ginkgo biloba is commonly used in dementia. It can be used in asthma, COPD, bronchitis, and in kidney as well as bladder disorders. It is a neuroprotective agent which is used in dementia. It has no specific mechanism. However, it is a plant. It is a natural occurring compound. Ginkgo biloba is used as dietary supplement, and it has claimed that it has many uses. Despite of its Chinese claims of medical uses and it has few adverse effects. It may cause GI related dysfunction. It may cause diarrhea and nausea and vomiting. Ginkgo biloba is mainly contraindicated in patients who are on anticoagulants, especially the one who is taking oral anticoagulants like warfarin. So ginkgo biloba interacts with warfarin and it potentiates the bleeding action. So it decreases the and it increases the anticoagulation activity of warfarin. So remember, ginkgo biloba is mainly contraindicated in patients who are taking warfarin. It may increase bleeding. So ginkgo biloba has no proven records which will increase the cognitive enhancement